First title defense, baby. Our first title defense. Let's go. This game's a lot of fun. It's really difficult to get good, I would imagine. Because there's so much to learn, but... There's Dominic Cruz. Awesome. Some press conference stuff? Let's go, baby. Got some press conference brouhaha.
Coming up next, a matchup for the UFC bantamweight division title.
Looking good with that belt, baby. Looking good with that belt, baby. Let's go.
Here's the former UFC bantamweight champion, Dominic Cruz. I feel like it's kind of unfair that he's not here to defend himself against you as he's making this walk, but ubiquitously regarded, DC, as the best bantamweight of all time.
I love that word, ubiquitously, or whatever. I don't know how to say it. It's beautiful, but if you're going to talk about someone and use that word, it needs to be Dominic Cruz, because he really is one of the greatest fighters this division has ever seen, one of the smartest guys that I've ever been around. Fights with me constantly at the commentary table.
He does.
But I love it because I feel like it brings out the most in both of us. And when Dominic Cruz is challenged, he always steps up. That's why he's been so successful in his big martial arts career.
We talk a lot about the footwork, the cardio, the striking. The one thing Dominic will tell you, if he needs to take a beating and lean on that heart and that toughness, he is more than willing to do so. Good to see Dom Cruz back on the proving ground here tonight. All right, so here he is, the UFC bantamweight champion of the world, making the walk for his first title defense. A lot of people say you're not the champion until you successfully defend the belt. An opportunity for him to do just that here tonight. Wrested the title away earlier this year. Now an opportunity to cement his championship legacy with his first championship title defense. Take for this, our main event of the evening. Cruz is 17 years his
senior. Man, this guy's 42 years old.
A 1-inch reach advantage. All right, now for the particulars, he is Bruce Buffer.
What?
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Herb Dean. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the Honda Center in Anaheim, California. It's time! Five rounds for the undisputed UFC bantamweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 24 wins, 4 losses. He stands 5 feet 8 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of San Diego, California, USA! Presenting the challenger, Dominic the Dominator
Cruz! This fight's gonna get real, baby.
Fighting out of the red corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 16 wins, 3 losses. He stands 5 feet 6 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Presenting, waiting, defending, undisputed UFC Bantamweight Champion of the World, Richie Boy.
Jay Manunka. If he ain't going to say it, I'm going to say it.
All right, so for the championship, you can give me your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves, just make it official.
My man doesn't like touching gloves with anybody.
Ready.
For the champion, this will be his first title defense, so he is focused on defending the belt, cementing his championship legacy. He believes that in order to be the champion, you don't just have to win the belt, you have to defend it, and he believes he will have more than enough to get the job done tonight.
Big powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
Oh, that straight punch was used to the champ.
Multiple times he's used this punch to get to the target. Look at that leg.
Cruz gets touched by that leg kick attempt. Trying to hammer that lead leg. Big shots being landed on both sides here. Uppercut attempt does not get to the target. Nice job defensively there by Cruz.
He has a commitment to kick it tonight, and it shows.
Throwing that jab yet again out of range. Wow, huge head kick. Now goes in and secures the takedown. Under 3 minutes remain in round one. Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. Oh, nice job working hard, posting, and getting back.
What's happening
up
here? Hello?
Notice the drive. Look at how they drive the knee right into the midsection.
You're okay.
Way to hide that leg kick.
That is a huge shot there, DC. I'm not sure how he stayed up.
I mean, when you get hit with a shot like that, to stay standing shows and talk to your coach.
Oh, he lands another takedown here. Just doing a nice job not telegraphing his shot. Clean entries. The Olympian's got to like what he sees.
I mean, over and over, he gets to the legs before his opponent reacts. By beating him on the entry, now it's up to the opponent to keep up. But this guy's playing chess. His opponent's playing checkers. He's playing chess. He can't keep up once he gets to his legs.
Ooh.
He's got to beat him defensively before he gets his hands locked around his legs or his body. Big kick lands. There's no tell on that leg kick.
Oh, effective strike there by Cruz. Oh,
I can't. Why am I
here? That's a way to leave an impression on the judges, and big picture, I think, could set him up for future success in the next round.
I can't guard against the takedown. I don't understand it. I'm like too slow, I think.
Action from that previous round, DC. A lot of good highlights on both sides.
I mean, a lot of good highlights from both competitors. They both should be very proud of what they accomplished. But I'm telling you, man, I'm not sure they can keep this up. If they land at this clip for another 5 minutes, somebody's going to sleep.
I am hitting L's left trigger and right trigger, but it's not working. I must be doing something else.
All right, so after he landed besides a high that number of kicks in the previous round, we'll see if he can keep it going here as our next round gets underway.
He should stay the course. He's so educated with his legs and his feet that he's given his opponent a very difficult time trying to anticipate what's coming his way. Ooh, what a head kick.
And he connects with the punch. All right, so he's landed some good shots. You hate to be overly critical, but nothing really in terms of combinations tonight.
Well, the jab has been looking great. How about jab, jab, right hand?
Right.
Because eventually you're going to have to put something on your opponent that's going to really make him pause. I believe the jab has been working so well, if he drops a big right hand after it, he may be able to finish his fight.
Slip that offering from his opponent. In the past, we've seen him sort of lean on the toughness. Tonight, he's leaning on the defense.
Can you see the evolution?
Double leg takedown.
Dude, what the
that is a
pissing me off?
He gets the fight back to the mat.
It's ideal. His ideal situation just happened. He got it on
all
the
right,
shot.
Nothing is happening. None of the buttons are working.
Finish. Great job. Got his guard pass.
Under 3 minutes now to go in round two. How about the speed on that reversal there? I mean, I know you can get out of some bad spots, but not with that type of speed.
You cannot allow him to get leverage on the bottom. What a sweep.
Both fighters get up now. A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. Cruz's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling. Man, how fun is this to watch as he continues to dole out damage with the ground and pound?
Take it back to the days of guys like Mark Coleman, just beating people up at the ground and pound. This guy is a throwback fighter and he's very fun to watch.
Yeah, the Godfather would be proud. Able to land the single ground strike there. Under a minute now to go on the round. Oh, nice job to reverse the ball. Good entry there to take the fight to the grappling realm. Now we'll see what he can do from here, champ.
This is exactly where he wants to be. Look for him to try to use ground and pound to open up submission opportunities.
All right, he'll engage in a single collar tie.
I mean, this guy is really focused on those punches to the head inside of the clinch.
Hip tosses him down. Now we'll see if he can advance position.
I mean, right into side control.
Ooh. And that's the end of round number two. All right, let's get you some pictures from that previous round, DC. A lot of good work with the ground and pound strike.
Yeah, he was able to control posture, get himself postured up.
I don't really know, like, why there's a huge delay on some of these things.
What a great finish to a fantastic round.
All right, DC, here we go with our next round. And how about the ground and pound skills in the previous round? His opponent better make some adjustments or mom's not gonna recognize him.
You're funny. He's got no actions to change this because this guy on top is so good with his pressure. He's not even controlling your body with his hands. And that's the detail that everybody's missing. He's sitting in that half guard, and his bottom half is securing his opponent. So his top half is moving. It's adjusting. He's posting his hand on his face, dropping elbows. When he's able to pull back, he's throwing his punches. There is a real...
Right.
I forgot the guy comes out strong in the third round.
His approach to his ground and pound. It is truly, truly great to watch. It is unbelievable to watch a guy so skilled in such an important area of fighting.
Oh, lands another beautiful strike to the body. Really starting to connect at will when it comes to working the body, and especially effective doing it later in this fight. Didn't see a lot of that from him in the earlier rounds.
He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks. That is, oh man, this dude is good.
Oh!
Look at how fast. The only person I can do this to is Baby John. John, there's a weight difference. I don't know if you know jiu-jitsu much. You miss a lot of your classes. If I'm gonna do this to anybody, it's Eddie.
Visibly limping here.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
Not there. Oh, he lands another
strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds.
What? I got what? What is with this game right now? My Xbox is going to explode.
All right, fighting out of the clinch here, and not for long. Nice trip to get the takedown.
Yeah, sometimes, John, you have a guy that is just so versatile. If they can do these takedowns in so many ways, you saw that on full display right there with that trip.
All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent.
Attacking it on
him. Oh, we're getting a finish here. And this might just be a matter of time. Not tapping out tonight. All right, side control now, DC. When you get side control in a fight, what are you looking for?
When I get to the side control of the fight, and I believe this young man...
I almost put an armbar on that dude.
It's secure first. Grab everything in tight. Make sure your elbows are in. Make sure you've got something locked in so your opponent doesn't just squirm away. Punch short punches, but try to make the opponent make a choice. Either he turns back into you.
Probably won the previous round. Your opponent might take some admit. So that guy came out on fire that round. And so the fact that I won that round is huge because that was his round.
All right, here we go. Fourth round of a possible five. And this is the time where fighters are really tested, right? Dig deep, lean on the heart, see who has the upper.
You feel pretty good in round number five. Round number four is the one that really does test the fighters. It really does test the mettle of the guy inside of the octagon.
Come on. What's happening?
Went for the inside leg kick.
When he drops his hands, throw it in.
Visibly limping here. Oh!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad. Oh, that was a really nice takedown.
Like, this game is just, like, not responding.
Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head. Or he's...
What a job to get the head kick home, and now his opponent in a world of trouble.
Such a sneaky head kick. He did not recognize his guy. And now he's got him hurt back.
All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent, you got to be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. All right, closed guard now. Got to be careful, though. He's got a lot of submissions off his back. Well, he works hard to get up again here, but he looks hurt. Oh!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh, he might be out. This is exactly the sense of urgency you're looking for. Try to take the judges out of it. He is lighting them up now.
Oh. Now he's on top of him looking for a finish.
Seconds to go.
Every time these guys come in,
we got it, baby. How's the fight going? The fight's going great. My Xbox seems like it's going to explode. But
what a performance!
Yeah, there's another one for the highlight reel. That's probably as good a knockout as he's had in the UFC. Just a perfect shot to end the fight. Crowd absolutely loving it. Flush land to close out his opponent. I'm not even sure the other fighter saw it coming. So a big knockout for him here tonight on the biggest of stages.
Came back just in time, yeah. He came out like crazy in the third round. That was his like in the scouting report. It's like he came out comes out big in the third round.
We send it in there now to Bruce Buffer.
Right, pretty much whooped his ass the whole time. I just can't
Ladies
defend the takedowns for some reason.
Dean is called to stop for this contest at 3 minutes 35 seconds of round number 4. Declaring the winner by
knockout.
And that is exactly the way he leaves. Successfully defends the bantamweight title by knockout.
He told us on Thursday nothing was going to change, and that was the exact truth. He went out there and he fought his fight. He stuck to the game plan. He did exactly what he said he was going to do, and he remains the UFC bantamweight champion.
Whoa, we like, yeah. What we got? Body health events. I had 3 knockdowns. He had 5 leg health events. So I was tearing into those legs again, Sparrow. I'm already at 6-month subs? Seriously? Big bag. Sub for 6 months. Nice. Appreciate all the support, man. Dude, I actually had him less than 70% accuracy. I mean, 50% accuracy. I wonder if that's my first time. Because I've been trying to focus on defense. And, yeah, I don't know.